Hi, now the system has the proper high frequencies and low frequencies presets, and the subs are aligned. According with particular needs or custom projects, we can apply other adjustments using three more tools from RDNet. The best shaper, the local zone FIR phase gain, and the full parametric equalizer with 8 bands. Let's see how and why to use these tools. By pressing the EQ button in any module, we'll assess at the DSP control window. The pink line represents the HF and the low frequency preset coming from our design main. Press Best Shaper. Here we have three controls to adjust the low cluster size. For instance, in a very curved cluster, probably, we'll have to reduce a bit the global amount of lows, as well as in a cluster with many modules, we may need to adjust the frequency slider. With the low frequency level, we can change the global amount of lows. With the frequency slider, we can move the cutoff point of the low shelving filter, and with the strength, we can adjust the slope of the low shelf, mainly emphasizing the EQ curve around the cutoff frequency zone. Anyway, in our case, the preset from Easy Shape Designer works as it is, so we don't need to make any changes. Let's apply again the preset from Shape Designer by pressing the low frequency apply in the venues window. As the bus shaper works on all the modules in the same way, talking about the HF, as you can see here, we have the possibility to work on 5 different zones. Differently from a normal group, an array can be divided in 5 zones, and for each of them, it is possible to apply 3 different FIR phase gains values at fixed frequency. In this way, we'll optimize the high frequency response along the audience area. Turn on the bands and type the gain values, otherwise you can move the points in the graphic on the right side. This advanced function has been developed in order to manage the HF sound according with the shape of the array. Let's see our design in Easy Shape Designer. Look at the first 3 modules. They are aimed in the far field and the angles among them are very small. From the 4th module to the 6th, we are aimed in the midfield with an higher values in the angles. The last modules are aimed in the near field, and the angles are bigger because of the spiral shape. This means that the coupling of the HF will be higher in the far field because the array shape is almost straight. In the midfield, and especially in the near field, where the shape of the array is more curved, it will be less and will give to the HF sound different tone. Right-click after selecting the first 3 modules of both the arrays and assign them to Array 1, Zone 1, the following 3 modules in the Array 1, Zone 2, and the last 2 modules in the Array 1, Zone 3. Now, by placing 3 microphones and taking the magnitude, or also just listening, in the 3 different locations, we can adjust the gain of these blocks, zone by zone, making the system response more homogeneous, moreover, without affecting the phase behavior of the array because of the FIR algorithm. In our system, we need to reduce by 2 dB the first band in the first zone to smooth a bit the HF in the far field. Just it. At this point, to solve other problems, we can use the 8 bands parametric equalizer. It can be useful, especially in indoor application, in which there could be standing waves or reflections. Here, we have gain, delay and polarity, which, if the device is assigned to an array or group, will affect all the devices together. At this point, you can press these buttons to see the intervention of each tool individually, or by pressing overall the global EQ curve of the clusters coming from all these tools together. Look at the frequency response of our 3 microphones. They are pretty similar. Of course, with an SP error reduction due to the distance, but the frequency response are very constant. Just a note, we suggest to read our line array system design white paper that you can find in our website in the download section technical documents to deepen in the system design techniques. It's really important. Now, let's save our project to recall and modify anytime you need and go to enjoy with the RCF sound. Thank you for viewing. Bye-bye.